face bom bom numai pentru tine. Numai pentru tine.
N-ai răspuns la telefon, no problem, te scot pe balcon și o să vezi cu ochii tăi cum ți-aduc flori în camion și îți cânt așa.
De tine, sunt întors pe dos, dos. Dacă să ajung la tine, trebuie să iau pe jos, jos. La ce ne folosesc banii, banii, banii? Dacă tu-mi dai iubire și zi de zi pun anii ca Bonnie and Clyde, să fiu doar eu cu tine. Și o să avem gal o iubire ca în filme.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Sports Arena Sentosa for the Samsung Senheng Purple League. We are live in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, the home of World Badminton. This is round 7, where today we're going to be watching Petaling Jaya versus Kepong. That's coming up just at 4 p.m. Later on today, we have Ampang Jaya versus Puchong United. Looking at the table here, Puchong United well ahead. They've got 80 points, games won. Kepong trying to catch up. They're on 59, six game played, and Petaling Jaya on 55. They need just 15 points to get up to the second place. And in today's match, they'll be looking for at least enough points to get safely into the top six of the round. So today we have Petaling Jaya versus Kepong.
Adalah di antara Ampang Jaya dan Puchong United.
And this is some of the action from Petaling Jaya in their last match. They were up against Petaling. Ligo Jeb Chen winning his match, and then in the men's doubles, you can see Tuan Chen struggling with his regular partner, Chua Kaming. Also, you see the mixed double struggling. Lee Chiu Kyu coming forward in the last match, taking a fine victory in his game. Now we can see Kepong Lim Chi Wing having a tough match against Sang Song. Yeah, he'll be looking to make up for that today. Ladies singles, Ayaho winning her match, but not in action today. Sugino for Kepong. Strong ladies singles for Kepong United again. Heroics on the court for Kepong, but not enough in the men's doubles there. They're looking for some improvement. Sung Ju Ben solid as ever, but again, will be replaced today by Lim Chi Wing in the men's singles number one.
But first, let me introduce you to the players for Kepong BC. Representing them in the men's singles, give it up for Muhammad Nur Aidil Adha Azman.
Apa yang bakal berlaku seketika nanti dan ketika ini sedang diperkenalkan kepada para penonton barisan pemain yang akan mewakili Kepong. Berikan tepukan kepada penampilan pertama untuk
Kepong
coming
out. It's a big moment for him.
Azman,
18-year-old
baru.
For the women's singles, Ho Yen-Mei.
Ho Yen-Mei, the national player, is in fine form. She's 3-0 for Kepong BC.
Yang pasti mau mengikatkan rekod baik.
The men's doubles will be represented by Nur Muhammad, Azrin Ayub, and Tan Tri Tan.
Azrin Ayub, an absolute favorite of the Purple League crowd. She's fun and exciting to watch. And Tan Tri Tan is national player partner in the men's doubles.
In the men's doubles, Chia Yizi and Go Soon Hwai.
Chia Yizi, also a national player in the mixed doubles. She's in great form, a 1-3 for her. Go Soon Hwai has had some mixed outings in the Purple League.
And representing Kambo with the first man singles, Lim Chi Wing.
Lim Chi Wing, an absolute veteran of the Purple League, and now Malaysian national player also. She's had some mixed form in the men's singles, winning two, drawing one, and losing one. And today, the coach Avril, Zachary Latif, coming out for Kapong.
And their team manager, Calvin Koo.
Calvin Koo.
The team manager will be hearing from
Pasukan.
Calvin Koo later on.
Now let's move on to Petaling Jaya, representing them in the men's singles category. Go Jap Chin!
This is Go Jap Chin. He is the talisman for Petaling Jaya. He loves to take scalps, and he's 4-2. Four wins, two losses. A real Purple League favorite already.
And for the women's singles, Lee Zi Yi.
This is Lee Zi Yi. She's making a comeback after a serious injury. Former national player. Great to see her coming out again for Petaling Jaya.
Representing Petaling Jaya in the men's doubles, Jackson Danoa and Lo Juan Shen.
Lo Juan Shen and Jackson Shin, former national player and current national player, pairing up today for Petaling Jaya in the men's doubles.
For the mixed doubles, Go Yeah Jing!
This is a debut for Go Yeching in the Purple League. She's a ladies' doubles player.
Turning
out today in the mixed doubles with Yogendran Krishnan.
For the first men's singles, Petaling Jaya is represented by Lee Chiu.
And it's the entertaining, fast and furious man from Hong Kong, is Lee Chiu Kyu.
Petaling Jaya is coached by Yeo Kai Lun and Kamal Dipsy.
And team manager, Manoj Kunar and Yeo Kai Lun.
And their team manager, Manoj Kumar.
Coming out for Petaling Jaya. They, of course, are the champions of last season's winning thrilling final. They look like they're in a good position to qualify for the final this year.
You can proceed with your cheers, and I will be speaking with your managers shortly.
Pastinya kita jangkakan satu pertandingan yang sengit saya.
See the teams go in to their customary bekas. Nice to see here, Stephanie.
Memang satu line-up yang cukup menarik.
Yes, so an exciting match we have up today. Of course, the men's singles is going to be an interesting tie-up. Anything there that takes your fancy?
Kedua-dua. For me, Go Gap Chin has always been the most consistent one here. But I would go more on Ho Yen Mei here playing against Lee Zi Yi because Lee Zi Yi has been really cautious about it. So we'll see on that. Singles here, women's singles.
So the lady singles, the one to watch out for from a former national singles player yourself, Stephanie, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so we've heard from Stephanie. Now we're going to hear from the team managers with Dayang Zainato.
Hey guys, we are still live from Sports Arena Sentosa, and today is another very exciting day between Kepong and also Petaling Jaya. Indeed, we are waiting for a very, very exciting day of badminton from the players that will be representing both teams today. And right now with me, we have the two team managers who will be telling us a little bit of information before we see today's action. So from Petaling Jaya BC, I noticed that this would be Jagdish's first appearance this season, isn't it?
Yes, correct. Yeah, his first appearance for the season. But he's all, for the fourth season in Purple League, he's always PJBC.
Okay, so most definitely he's going to give a very good show for today. And for Kepong, we know that for this first stage, we know that Puchong United has been very strong. But the number two spot is still up for grabs. So does Kepong plan to go that way or something?
Yeah, for every tie that we go in, we try to put at the strongest lineup. So every chance is possible, but we are not building any pressure since we are already qualified for top six.
Okay, so another very interesting thing about Petaling Jaya is I always pay a lot of attention towards the mixed doubles pairs. So what can you share with us about your pair for today?
About the mixed doubles, we always have a scratch pair. We want to try something new with the players because We are in the already top six, so we qualify to the Genting. So we want to try the few scratch pairs where we can use in the finals in Genting. So that's why we always scratch the pairs, because some our main mixed double player Prajata is not here. She's involved in the India League. So I hope other players can perform and get along with Yogen and Tanish, see which pairs perform very well.
Okay, so it's been six ties so far for both Kepong and Petaling Jaya, and both of you have had three wins and three losses. For Kepong, what's the game plan for today?
Yeah, as you can see, our first singles will be Ideal. Well, there's no pressure on Ideal. I think the pressure will be on Gyapchin, right? Because Ideal is considered an underdog in this match, which in turn will probably turn to Ideal's advantage. So I just told Ideal to play his game, no pressure at all, and let's see how it goes.
I think the pressure is usually on the viewers, always at the edge of our seats. Okay, thank you very much, gentlemen. Let's shake hands to show good sportsmanship, and we will be going back to our commentators.
Well, interesting that first main singles, as you heard from Manoj and Calvin, Gojapchin is not the underdog, and that is where he likes to be. He likes to take the pick.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the main singles category between Kepong and Petaling Jaya, our umpire is Nur Juhaida Muhammad Azhar, and the service judge is Lim Zouche.
Yeah, seperti yang
he said that Gojapchin in the unfamiliar position of not being the underdog in this match, Stephanie. Nuraido Azazman is his opponent today.
Yes, and it was very different because Gojapchin was the underdog, so he went in without any pressure.
Kita mengejangkakan satu permainan yang menarik walaupun tekanan itu sebenarnya sudah semestinya ada, tetapi bagaimana pemain itu sendiri untuk mengatasi tekanan dalam permainan yang berlangsung pada perlawanan pertama ini.
Jadi
sememangnya pertandingan penting untuk Nur Aidil.
And the man himself, the bundle of energy, Gojapchin, already a favorite with many Purple League fans. Most recently, he was able to get another scalp again over Kenichi Taigo in his match against Petaling BC. Of course, I memorably beat Kenichi Taigo in the quarterfinal of the final stages last year, which was a big surprise, but he's a master of using the course conditions to his advantage.
Wu Songjian, Tan Jiawei, dan juga Yu Chen. Jadi memangnya seorang pemain yang berwibawa dan pastinya menjadi tonggak harapan petaning jaya untuk tiga mata pertama agaknya.
So Gojapchin choosing to serve with the, let's say, the drift
pemain yang sudah pun bersiap sedia untuk perlawanan pertama di antara Petaling Jaya dan Kepong.
There's watch up how the court conditions have really been affecting many of the games that we've seen so far, Stephanie.
Yes, and knowing Gojapchin is now the drift is behind him, he has to be giving a lot of low shots, like a lot of attacking shots instead of lobbings, which is going to the baseline, because that's the risk it will be for Gojapchin to take.
Gojapchin from Pulau Penang in Malaysia, age 24, 71 in the world, recently got Iskander Zainuddin in the Chinese Taiwan Open. It's the highest ranking he's ever had. Nuraido Adha Azman, a totally different stage in his career, is only 18 years old. Mainly played mixed doubles on the circuit, so it'll be interesting to see how he fares against something of a veteran master already in the form of Gojapchin. No pressure on him, according to the manager, Calvin
Koo.
It can be no pressure at times, but because Nur Aidil, he also want to perform really well because the viewers are here, so there will be also a little bit pressure that he doesn't lose so badly, so he would also want to be there to, you know, give a good fight for Gyapchin or even take over.
Yeah, because as you say, this is the chance for him to make a name for himself and of course get some vital experience in let's say a big stage in front of the cameras and the whole of Malaysia watching. So hopefully we'll see an exciting match. As they say, we don't know much about young Azman, but we hope he can give a good account of himself. Kepong, of course, are pretty safe in the standings. If they take 15 points today, then they will be able to get into the second place position, having played seven matches.
Kedua-dua klub ini, jadi kedudukan mereka dalam
enam yang terbaik adalah selamat dan agak jauh. They're in, currently they're in sixth place on 55 points. If they get 15, they will go technically into the second place. But
tapi rasanya rosak yang mereka akan cuba bersaing adalah untuk
Ampang Jaya
yang lebih tinggi untuk mengelakkan bersama dengan Puchong.
Ampang Jaya
itulah seperti yang dilakukan oleh yang berada di tangga terbawah.
And on my left, Kepong BC.
Ideal bersiap sedia untuk melakukan servis pertama beliau dalam SS Super League musim ini.
Kepong BC to serve. Level. Play.
So umpire Nur Juhaida gets this intriguing match underway.
Dua-duanya terlalu gelap pada petang ini. Dua-duanya berhati-hati dari kedua-dua pemain.
Look at that, that's exactly what you said, Stephanie.
And it's surprising because Gapchin there, he knows that the drift is behind him, so he has to be really careful to give baseline shots.
Of course, blood to Asman, and look at the power in that attack. He's obviously settling any nerves by going straight on the offensive.
Taking the advantage at the half court was a good comment from Ideal there.
Kedua dalam game yang pertama. Itu dia.
Go Gapchin coming back in at the net. You said he would be playing more towards the net and playing sort of low flat shots because of the drift there, right?
Yes, and that's why I feel that it should be a lot of smashes and then soft touches more.
Smash dapat dikembalikan oleh Gapchin.
Now the soft touch deserting Go Gapchin there. I wonder if he's feeling the pressure for a change.
He can be really good with that front shot, but at times if he's being too cautious about it, it can cause him a mistake like what he just did.
Servis diberikan 3-1 untuk Ideal. Satu jumping smash.
There we go, that will settle the net. Christian said already that Gapchin likes to go into the big matches as the underdog and cause the surprise, and so now he's expected to perform. Do you think that will play on his mind at all?
It will. But at the same time, I think he knows how good he has performed, and that's going to give him that confidence he needs.
Dan 2-3 tolakan daripada Ideal agak mendatang terus
close level 3-0.
And Ideal, he has to get used to playing with Gapchin's style because this is just the beginning. He doesn't know how to come in, and also the first 3-4 points is more for him to open up the game, to learn on how to play. 4-3.
Yang keempat untuk Gapchin mendahului buat kali pertama. Ideal.
Wonderful drop shot from the Ideal. He really is showing that he has something to offer this crowd in this match.
Lompat untuk melakukan.
That's a really slow touch there, which is not very easy to do sometimes because it's being very deceptive in the baseline.
Do you think that sometimes if an established player like Go Gapchin comes up against an unknown player, it's harder for them to play because they can't read the style of game?
I will agree to this because he's also under pressure, and then to learn someone else who has never played against, it's also on him to learn more.
5-4. So 3 minit permainan.
They're still ahead.
2-2 pemain ini.
5-4 on the serve. Another error from Go Gapchin. Now he's made 3 unforced errors so far in this match.
Satu lagi mata untuk Ideal. Tidak lepas.
Is that just not quick enough at the net, or lapse in concentration from Go Gapchin?
And for Gapchin, if he knows he's doing many mistakes in the front, he should probably just push it to the behind side, you know, to just see how is it going, because it's not working in the front court.
Smash dapat dikembalikan. Sekali lagi Gapchin.
So recover.
Quick from Go Gapchin.
Shot dan cantik.
Still 2 points down here.
Very quick to take the shot baseline.
Kali terperangkap ID dari pukulan Gapchin yang begini. Masih 8 lagi dari Gapchin. Masih lagi di depan jari.
Again, Go Gapchin surprised by the speed and punch of Nur Ideal.
Dia melakukan sedemikian. Menambahkan mata untuk Ideal, 8-5. Game pertama ini. Terkena atas jaring. Jatuh pada manggang Ideal.
twice already Aidil has made the mistake on his left hand side of the block. So he should be very cautious there because Gap Chin's overhead smash is really fast and sharp.
Nah, untuk Gap Chin.
I have to say Nur Aidil seems to be sharp as well, but he's blasted that one out, just out.
Smash daripada Aidil.
Close though.
Yang jelas daripada garisan.
You sing about the front row area. Another mistake from Nur Japchin.
Tidak kurang berpuas hati dengan apa yang berlaku tadi.
Is much slower than the usual of Nur Japchin.
Pasti mahu diperbetulkan oleh Japchin. 9-7 untuk Aidil. Biarkan jatuh di luar daripada Japchin.
Game point
bagi Nur Aidil Adha.
Nur Japchin moving at full pace, but he couldn't control it. An unlikely game point here for Kepong.
Saved
by Go Jepchen, the first one at least. So, three game points for Kepong. Nur Aidil just has to get one more to convert.
The service Aidil tadi.
Go Jepchen now catching up, but still a risky position for Petaling Jaya here.
He's giving in too much to Japchin to attack, so he should be playing a lot of flat shots for Aidil. That's when he can prevent Japchin from attacking.
That's 10 sama, right?
Game point 4.
And now it's a double game point situation. Go Japchin settling his nerves just at the right moment. Is this going to go the way of Kepong or Petaling Jaya?
Siapa di antara kedua-dua pemain ini?
He came really fast there, but then it was a mistake made by Japchin there where he could have just given a straight smash, probably to just save it instead of, you know, giving it accurately at the side.
It's a flash advice that are coming too late for Petaling Jaya in game one. Nur Aidil Adha Azman. Dan mewakili Kepong Bisi.
As
we look at some of the highlights from the first game.
Yes, we can see, yeah, a lot of Aidil shots towards the 8th point, but after that, I felt he was giving in a lot of three-quarter point shots for Japchin to attack. As for Japchin, his mistakes was one of the main reasons why he could lose this game. And we see for Aidil here that he has actually won a lot in the front. It's only 3 points because it was more of Japchin's mistakes that cost him this game.
Yeah, and that really shows in the shot chart there. He's 8 on 4 there from Japchin, pretty much giving that first game to Kepong. But now the tables have turned now. On this side of the court, the pressure will be on Kepong because this is where the drift is behind them. Now, what we've seen with this drift in this Sports Arena Hall is that forces the player on Nur Aidil's side of the court to moderate every shot that goes to the back of the court. So you tend to see them playing more in the front court area.
So
this makes it more difficult to get on the attack.
If Japchin can convert his front shots really well, and then there's his game. If that's not working, then Japchin always gets a little bit pressured and nervous that he can't really play.
Oh, cubaan, tapi backhand beliau sukan.
Usually the one that comes out all guns blazing, but he's up against somebody he's never played before, so he didn't know quite what to expect. And all those errors led to Kepong taking the first game. And this young man is already turning heads, I would say, with some fine attacking play. We've seen a lot of, let's say, 18-year-olds come into the Purple League and really struggle to get their first game, their first point, maybe playing very passively. We're certainly not seeing that with Nur Aidil Azman today.
Peluang untuk gol Japchin.
Sekali lagi. That has gone in, so
3-2.
Azman lifting a little bit short and getting punished for it, but Japchin's in a real fight here, Stephanie.
Yes, and his Aidil's lunges when he went in the front was much slower. And that's why he had to struggle to take the half court. It was a half court shot for Japchin to do a good smash. 4-2.
Bad net error there by Nur Aidil. quick serve and smash from Gojep Chin.
Oh,
yeah, slammed it in. And that's how you win a shot from the back of the court using a clear now. Let's have a look at it again. Just on the line. Very close.
Ideal hanya mengharapkan shot tersebut jatuh di luar.
You see how Nur Adil is now making all the mistakes.
Terus meningkat mata untuk Go Gyap Chin dalam game kedua ini 6-2.
He's against the wind now.
Right, sekali lagi keruan sama.
Be careful. He hits with enough force to penetrate into the deep areas, right?
Yes, that's very true because he just has to be not too cautious or look too careful to go on the defense, but just get it safe because he has lost the first game and this is the game.
7-3.
Deteksi yang pantas.
Of course, Jep Chin, as you recall from the coin toss, he did opt to go on the harder side of the court. He's regretting that decision now.
Jelas,
this is comfortable
yang begitu baik daripada Go Gyap Chin.
Well in the lead.
For Ideal, he shouldn't be very complacent now because just because he has won the first game, the second game was so many mistakes and we can see another unforced error. So he should come back and just think that he has to win instead of just winning the first game and being happy about it.
That's right, and he's got nothing to lose at all whatsoever. He's already got a fantastic achievement in getting a game of proper league. There's some players that we know haven't even had that achievement. But as you say, he's still under no pressure. Why not go for broke? Try to catch up in game two. But it's game point still for Bedling Jaya here.
Sidia, terlepas dari kawalannya. Service dari Ideal. 4-10. Tidak lama. Terus kemenangan bagi Go Gyap Chin dengan satu smash.
Jep Chin. Which was good for him that Ideal couldn't really clear it and it was half guard. So just the best way for Gyap Chin to give a cross court shot because Gyap Chin is very fast in his cross court smashes. Now, now,
now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now, now,
now, looking at the highlights now, we can see that this time it was the other way around where Ideal made more of the mistakes compared to Gyap Chin. And for Gyap Chin, his front works, it worked compared to the first set. Most of his spinning net and his attacking, he was not like going accuracy, but more on just keeping it safe on the court.
And would you say that the front court area is a strong point for Go Gyap Chin?
It is because he is forward, always moving forward really fast. And Gyap Chin's points were here, I believe it's his smashes, his attacking points or his baselines as well.
So the smashes are coming from the front court shots is what you're saying?
Yes.
Interesting stuff from Stephanie.
Satu sama ketika ini. Yang terkedua dua pemain. Kita terus ke game yang ketiga. Baru saja
berhenti. Wow. Pertama untuk pemain muda Kepung. Confidence I feel the players are getting from playing into the drip, Stephanie.
Yes, because you don't have that pressure of playing against the wind now. Because when you are here, it's always in your mind. You know, you want to focus at the same time. You're also thinking of how do I get the shot not going out.
Sama. 1-0, game 2.
Rally. Ambil oleh
Gyap Chin. Quick by Nur Adil, but not quick enough.
Shuttle di jaring Ideal.
At first he went, he was like off balance behind there and he shouldn't have done that shot because he could have just given a straight drop instead of making that kind of a chop shot cross court.
2-1, oh baik, dapat diambil oleh Gyap Chin. Smash the top.
Bye-bye, Nur Adil. Adson is certainly turning heads in this match. I have to say I haven't seen too many players can match Mr. Go Gyap Chin for speed around the court, but Nur Adil has certainly been that today.
Kandas di jaring dua sama dalam game yang ketiga.
3-2.
Another mistake by Go Gyap Chin at the front court area. Puts
Nur Adil
in front.
Ideal cuba bangkit dalam game yang ketiga ini. Tapi smash untuk
Gyap Chin. 3-2. three.
No, he doesn't look happy with that shot.
Yeah, he went wide out, but like I said, sometimes, you know, when you play those kind of shots, it's better to play safe, knowing that, you know, when you go so much for thinking of the wide, he might go wide out.
Sava, four, three.
It's a real pattern of mice being played here. Another player showing their best form, a lot of mistakes already in the second game. Guts and glory, kind of effort from both players. I mean, 110%, you can see.
Dibiarkan.
Jatuh di luar. Struggling every time, and Japchin just slow movement drop, and that is where Ideal has to be more faster to come for his footworks in the front to speed up his game.
You see there.
Five. Four.
It's a slower ball from Gojapchin, which caught out Ideal. And just sense that, as you're saying, Stephanie, this front court area is really where the battle is being won or lost, because both players are so powerful on the attack. Anybody that loses that front court battle is forced to lift.
Ruang to Ideal.
You cannot be very undecided when you take those kind of shots, because most of the time it doesn't work unless you are like, we did see Chong Wei maybe can do that, but it's not very often people, it's a risk you take when you do those kind of undecided shots you take.
Again, a powerful attack from Gojapchin, breaking through the defense of the Ideal. Now, I have to say, the Ideal is looking a little bit befuddled in this match. A few things haven't gone his way, and it's now Gojapchin that is inched ahead. And his judgment is better on this occasion.
To create those kind of chances, Ideal should. That's why they play a lot on the front court for Gojapchin to lift, and then there's a chance of it going wide out, because, as I said, he is behind the drift for Gojapchin.
Memberikan mata yang ke-8 kepada pemain PJ itu, Gojapchin.
Both players already absolutely drenched in sweat, and it's been an absolutely exciting start, and the drama continues.
He's just coming in one after another. You know that follow-up is actually very important when you do a smash, coming back in front with your racket high up there.
You really can't fault this young guy for effort, can you? There he's... that's gone out. Interesting. I wonder if we'll take a look at that one again, because I think that even surprised Gojapchin to a certain extent. But what a great call.
Jatuh di luar untuk mata ke-9.
Samisova, 7, 9.
Gojapchin just gives it straight back to
Noraido. Untuk mata ke-7 bagi Noraido.
He's only got a 2-point advantage here, but will it be enough? Mereka.
Service daripada Noraido.
There's that front court play again, Stephanie.
This time it worked for Gojapchin, and that's the advantage which I always say that Gojapchin should use when he is playing against any opponents.
Sesuai untuk smash dilakukan. Game point untuk Gojapchin.
Game.
Itu dia.
It
seemed to me that Gojapchin was now beginning to know how Ideal plays, and he's getting used to it, and that's how it should be. Although that he could have started off earlier in the first set, the first game, and now the highlights here was pretty much both of them doing fine, but Gojapchin's attacking, unforced errors compared to Ideal, who made a lot of mistakes at the baseline.
Yeah, and you saw that in the red, all those red dots on the shot chart there. So Gojapchin finding his mark on his attacks, and also crucially finding the mark at the front court area and set up those attacking chances. So
Kalinjaya 2, Kepung 1.
Incredible stuff here.
mencuba untuk mencari kemenangan dalam game yang
keempat.
Pada masa ini, banyak masa lagi dari Ayer masih berpeluang.
Probably the two noisiest sets of supports you probably hear a lot of drums, a lot of banging going on in the background. Well, that's the reason why.
Dibiarkan.
There you see Muraido getting caught out, balas punching it long with the drift.
Data kuat ke bahagian belakang.
The flick shot was a good idea from Ideal, but probably he forgot that the drift is always there to cause him for the shuttle go out.
Data pasti bawa risiko jatuh di luar kawasan permainan.
It's quite a mental trick to somehow adjust your game. Mid-play to something like that, it requires intense concentration.
Yes, because you are in different sides all the time. And one side, you know, you have to be very careful of the baseline shots, and the other one, you have to be very careful. It's always the opposite, you know. So yes, intense focus is very important.
Tinggi, Jap Chin.
That one going out. It's close. We saw Go Jap Chin scored a great winner on a similar shot in game one.
Liao, agak baik.
This one he didn't control correctly. Line judge calling it out. Muraido back on serve.
Jadi mata untuk Ideal.
Game three. Kepong versus Peddling Jaya. This is the Samsung
Senhei.
We watch this young man Muraido give a pretty incredible performance playing with so much heart.
Atas daripada Ideal. Mata yang ketiga dalam game yang keempat ini untuk Ideal dari Kepong.
One down overall. So.
Quality. Peluang dan itu dia kesilapan antara
time luar. Chin Wong putting Muraido. Just wonder if he sent some tiredness there in the legs.
And he went too deep behind there to take it. And that kind of shots, he could probably just drive the shot instead of clearing it.
Oh, berjaya dikembalikan oleh Gap Chin. Tetapi itu dia. Baik daripada Ida.
Muraido. Incredible. Look at the height on this. So confident down the line, beats yet again the defense of Go Jap Chin.
Melarikan Go Jap Chin.
It's a real momentum with Kepong at the moment.
And Ideal is using his advantage of he is powerful and he's using it more often in this particular game, and that's really helping him.
Mendalui dengan kelebihan 4 mata.
Three, six.
Jap Chin won't be rolled over easily.
Tandas di jaring daripada
smash from a half-court lift of Muraido. Changes the momentum once again.
3-6. Luang. Mudah bagi Jap Chin menyerang.
Setting yang dilakukan. Probing play by Go Jap Chin.
Yes, and the struggle in the front, that it's like a double lunge, he's doing it, but it's just not fast enough.
Return. Service kedudukan 4-6.
Oh, wonderful stuff. Quality daripada Go Jap Chin. Don't need to hit hard from that possession.
Menirukan Muraido. Tidak mahu melakukan smash.
I really feel that all that effort of Nur Ideal Azan has really tired him out. You see his legs look a little bit drained there.
Dari
it through the defense of Gojak Chen at the back of the court. Again, the cleverness of Gojak Chen just punching one past. A little bit of information for you. We have Zachary Latif in the coach's chair, but sitting next to him is Nuridel's father, watching his debut performance in the Purple League. And
I'm truly impressed with Aidil's game model, because for him to start off here and knowing the crowd is here, this is probably one of his first times playing, so it's really impressive to see how Aidil has performed so far.
Zachary Latif berbincang saat ini yang terbaik untuk pemain muda.
In a sense, he's really just doing exactly what the team manager told him to do, which is to go out and play with no pressure, Stephanie.
Yes, and he has, like, I believe, also that feeling of being very proud that he's now representing, you know, Kapong, and then going against Goh Gyap Chin is not that easy.
Goh Gyap Chin.
Is 9-6 up. Another mistake in the front court area by Gojak Chen.
Itu kesilapan diri sendiri yang dilakukan oleh Gojak Chen.
There you are, you see the tricks. It's really interesting to see how Gojak Chen is using everything out of the playbook which he has to stay
in front of
this young man from Kepong.
Long idea. Kembalikan oleh Gyap Chin. Pantas. Kencang smash daripada Gyap Chin. Sebelah kiri aja.
It was a fast forehand smash from Goh Gyap Chin, because he did not even wait for the shuttle to move behind him. He was just so quick to come back there and just get a straight smash.
It's almost as if Goh Gyap Chin has to be one step ahead of his opponent all the time.
Begitu rapat sekali, 8-9.
Satu mata diperlukan. Ideal.
Now that he knows the fact Aidil is leading him 10-8 at the moment.
With the chance almost taken. Still has two more left. Gyap Chin, of course, was nowhere near it, but it went out.
Satu mata yang dicari oleh kedua-dua pemain ini.
Dibiarkan satu di luar. Melepaskan dari kemenangan dalam game yang keempat ini. Nur Aidil showing that Nur Aidil like in the second game, it was no fluke what he did in the first game. Working that front court area, making life very awkward for Gojak Chin. Forcing a mistake to take game two.
Jelas kita dapat lihat beliau membuka pergerakan ataupun pukulan beliau. 11-9. Masuk 3 minit. Impressive-nya ayah dia kepada Aidil Adha. Memberikan
galakan. Take us through game 4, Stephanie.
Yeah, looking at the highlights here, Donald, Aidil, he knows that he's a little bit slow in the front, so he managed to convince, or he managed to convert there to go move faster in the front. So his legs, although he was tired, we know that he did really well in the front court. And he get many of his points came from the baseline of, actually it was a lot of the attacking shots that helped him with his power. He really went all up. He did not give a play.
We saw him leaping really high as well to get those attacking shots.
Itu yang terhasil dalam game keempat. Okay, game ini game penentuan. Siapa yang menang, beliau akan menang.
Just getting control of the net there.
Itu saja. That's
too much aggression from him. Who knows?
Untuk Goh Gyap Chin dalam game yang kelima ini.
Yes, this time it's going to be tricky to see both of them now going, especially 25 minutes plus.
This has been one of the most, been one of the fastest and most furious matches we've ever had in Puzzle League. The pace at which the games have been played is utterly incredible. As you say, we've got four games already, and we're now into the fifth with just more than 5 minutes left on the clock.
Oh, by Polakan daripada Gap Chin.
Polakan's big struggle. Gap Chin yet again showing some great deceptive shots at the front court area and causing problems for Naraido.
Daripada Gap Chin.
Oh, well judged by Gap Chin. It was in.
It was a shooting lob, a flat lobbing. It's not like a high lob, and that was fine from Gap Chin because he didn't want to go really fast to get it baseline.
Naraido gets the shuttle straight back again.
Big leap for Ideal is helping him because that is actually very deceptive, not knowing for Gap Chin what is he going to do, and he's very good with his crossbar chop, so he can either do a smash or a chop. So his big leaps are really an advantage for Ideal.
Continues to sway one way or another. Gap Chin again with a narrow advantage at 4-2.
Diambil oleh Ideal.
Decision at the backcourt from Ideal.
Another
mistake from Gojang Chin.
Lantan tolakan yang memaksa Gap Chin melakukan kesilapan. Satu lagi mata dipungut oleh Ideal. Sekali lagi.
Another quick punch from Gojek Chin. We've seen a lot of winners in quickly taking shots on the serve.
Yes, Ideal, a few times I was just going to say that whenever he serves, he does a low service, he's not extremely ready for Gap Chin's shot. Many of times that he's just losing the shuttle.
Long smash ke sebelah kiri, Ideal.
He's losing a bit of concentration when Gap Chin or himself is serving. A good put away there from Gap Chin. Solid smash into the corner.
Mereka akan bertukar gelanggang kerana ini adalah game penentuan, game kelima.
By now, Ideal should know the pattern of Gap Chin every time he serves the low service. Where are the possibilities that Gap Chin has hit? But I feel Ideal is still not hitting it yet. He's still not in control of the shots which Gap Chin will possibly do.
As someone who intimately knows the Malaysian badminton game, how representative would you say that Nur Ideal is of the talent pool which are not known to us, but which still have a chance to come and shine on the big stage?
Yes, and so then now for Ideal especially, this is a good, probably for the national team to see that he's really doing well for an 18-year-old. It's a good opportunity for even the national team to see.
Of course, against a player like Gojek Chin with a big reputation, as Nur Ideal puts away another shot to bring it to 5-6. Can't think of a better effort for this young man, so real fire being shown from him. Guts and glory, we have a new star for Kepong.
Just the idea keeps Gojek Chin in the mark. 7-5
now to Pedaling Jaya. It's a great chance. Gojek Chin certainly having to use every ounce of energy, experience, skill, the strategy that he can muster. This is very lively young man from Kepong BC. 7-5, Gojek Chin on serve.
Satu lagi mata untuk Gojek Chin.
Chin is the receiving service. Call the service receive or the service shot that Gap Chin is punching every time.
For Gap Chin, he's taking advantage of that because many of the times he's more consistent than I thought.
It's almost as if he knows where to put the shuttle and knows what to do with it. He's got several years more experience to learn that type of craft.
9.
significant point for Gujiat Chin. Now there's still a timer at 6-9 for Muraido. He's on serve, but he has to do something here. And he's called it short. So this is now match point. Terrible way for this game to end if it goes the way of Gujiat Chin. I have to say he has fought more bravely towards the latter stages of this game five.
Match point untuk Gujiat Chin. Amat baik untuk pemain PJ ini.
Dibiarkan keluar dan itu dia kembali. It's the end of the match and it's a rather tame ending compared to the absolute war that we have witnessed.
Game yang kedua,
satu forehand shot out down the line and Gujiat Chin runs out the winner. Confirmation of the score is 10-11, 11-4, 7-9-11. It was 2-all, remember, and then 5-11-6 in the last fifth game.
Yang ditunjukkan oleh Aidil.
Let's do some of the highlights here from the match, Stephanie.
Yes, and then we can see that this game was actually not that Gujiat Chin was not playing so well. It was Aidil that performed really out of our expectations.
Yeah, I got the sense that Gujiat Chin started the match and realized very quickly that there was someone very hard to handle here.
Yes, and his mistakes cost him a lot for Gujiat Chin that he lost in the second and third, the first set, I say. But for Aidil here, he would have been, he was really powerful in his baseline side, but in terms of his front court, his lunges and his footwork has to be a bit more faster.
And he was getting caught out by those deceptive front court shots of Gujiat Chin, wasn't he?
And he was not so focused on that receiving and the service which we have discussed just now.
So that's interesting that we saw a different dimension to Gujiat Chin. He found something else to overcome his opponent. A little bit of craft in that front court area, bringing him through. So this is some of the VR action that we see here.
And yeah, we see Gujiat Chin there. That was actually a shot where, you know, just last minute you turn your racket face. And then now, one more time, doing that same deceptive shot.
He's a real master at that shot, isn't he? The soft drop.
We've always seen Gujiat Chin really fast and good at that one.
And this is, I think he's going to do the same shot, but on the other side. So just putting the pressure on the footwork, as you were saying, of Nur Aidil. So look at the stats here. Unforced errors, unsurprisingly, 22 from the youngster, but a lot of new court winners from him as well. But Gujiat Chin in the end, the 71 ranked player in the world prevailing against the Kepong player. A great performance from Nur Aidil in his first debut match. So coming up soon, we're going to have the ladies' singles. Lee Zi Viet fighting back from injury against Ho Yen Mei. That will be a cracker coming up.
Thank you.
Well, welcome back to the Sports Arena Sentosa. We just had an enthralling men's singles. Go Jeff Chin defeating Nur Aidil Adha. Jasmine 3-2. The ladies' singles coming up with Lee
Si-Yi. Di mana persorangan wanita
representing Kepong, give your support for Ho Yen Mei.
Ho Yen Mei.
Ho Yen Mei in fantastic form in the Purple League. She is 9-0 for Kepong BC.
Yang sekali lagi di
and representing Petaling Jaya, Lee Si-Yi.
Record yang baik.
Lee Si-Yi making an appearance, fighting back from a horror injury. Can only be described as that, and we'll talk to Stephanie Sherini very shortly about that. As we look at the players coming onto the court,
kakak for the coin toss. Pemain negara yang baru saja dipilih untuk menyertai skuad Piala Thomas dan Lee Si-Yi membuat penampilan kali kedua musim ini untuk Petaling Jaya BC. Jadi mungkin di atas kertas ataupun mengikut form book, mungkin Ho Yen Mei yang akan diberikan pilihan, tetapi Lee Si-Yi pasti akan bersemangat untuk menambahkan mata bagi Petaling Jaya.
Side of court and Lee Si-Yi will be on serve.
No,
Stephanie, Lee Si-Yi fighting back from injury. She's got her left leg heavily strapped up there. That was the one that was horrifically injured. I think it was in the Swiss Open in 2016. What does it mean when you get an injury like that for a singles player? For your career,
it is very demotivating because whenever you want to come back to play, it takes a while for you to actually recover from it because you always have that fear that you're going to get it injured again. So that will probably be for Z at this time here, because the previous time when I watched her playing the Purple League, I felt that she still had that pain, or she felt that you know she's going to get injured again when she played against Goh Jin Wei.
Interesting. So it's something of a mental battle as well that the player has to overcome. So that makes perfect sense now to watch her warm up. As we said, she was almost in the top 100. A 21-year-old from Kedah, Malaysia, Al Setar, she was born. She started playing when she was 10 years old. And of course, she had that terrible injury which has kept her out of most of 2017. And now, as you see her coming back in 2018, Ho Yen Mei, on the other hand, is a veritable veteran of the national team and the Purple League. She's also 21-year-old, very local Kuala Lumpur player. And Grace Chua, ranked number 68 in the world. She's one of a number of Malaysian players that are just starting to break through into the world scene. So, your predictions for this one, Stephanie?
It will go for me, it will be Ho Yen Mei, because not only because she is struggling, because as I've known Yen Mei since a young age, she has always been this very skillful player. Her wrist work is always, I was always very impressed with her wrist work, so I feel that this game will definitely go to Yen Mei.
And you think that, you know, you can always say, well, what would have happened, but if Si-Yi hadn't had an interrupted career, would it be the same story, do you think, in this match, or would it be a bit closer?
It would have been, because now that Si-Yi is slowly coming back, for her to actually, she had a rest about a year plus, and then it was probably everything else would have brought her down, and now she's just building up her confidence. So if all this would not have happened, Si-Yi would be really good, because she has the advantage of her height as well.
So, interesting. Petaling Jaya, we have Lee Si-Yi. So, Pong, we have Ho Yen Mei. And as we said, Ho Yen Mei is in very good form. She's 3-0 in the Purple League. And what you were talking about, her wrist work, I fully agree with. Also, I admire quite a lot her tactical brain on the court. She really knows how to unlock her opponent. So, it will be interesting to see if she shows any mercy in this match. But we're picking her perhaps as the slight favorite. But we're just happy to see Lee Si-Yi come back, as anybody would.
They both do train together as well, so both of them will actually know each other's game. It's only that
ladies and gentlemen,
wanting to take the advantage
my right,
of Petaling Jaya BC, represented
by Lee Si-Yi. And on my left, Kepong BC, represented by Ho Yen Mei. Petaling Jaya BC to serve level play.
Servis daripada Si-Yi. Mata pertama untuk Ho Yen Mei.
Quick net shot from Ho Yen Mei. Sama-sama,
one,
attacking the serve of Lee Si-Yi. Another cute net shot.
hadapan.
Love.
Rocked over by Ho Yen Mei. Such a delightful touch she has.
Untuk Ho Yen Mei.
Ziggy finding out about
three,
the drift that's behind her.
He's
playing with Sam Nason on the court the other day, and I can tell you it is really quite a strong wind that can really catch you unawares from Ziggy's side of the court.
Smash, kencang di sebelah kiri.
Terus saja Ho Yen Mei. The drift. So in the first game, she used that to build the confidence because she did not expect to put the shuttle long at the back. See Lee Ziyi snatching a point back and getting herself to a start.
Four. Yes, and Ziyi should.